compared to a normal platform game, what's different in a VR platform?
I think the judging gap between two platforms, because you can judge in 3D over there, needs to come over here very precisely. No, yeah, I'm gonna make that.
It's true that in a platform game, typically on a normal TV game, the camera is one of the most critical parts of those games. If it's a bad camera, it can make the game impossible to play.
You are the
VR, you are the camera.
VR game creation is completely different. We can't use the knowledge of classic game, so we have to find the solution in the level design. On Astrobot, player doesn't go around too much. Player goes in the straight line.
I was really surprised when playing the game where you said, you know, the player goes in a straight line. When you play through a level, you feel you've gone up and down and left and right, and it's the way the level is cleverly built around you with like proximity and then far away and then down and up, and you have this experience of all these movements, but actually physically you have been moving in a straight line, and that's why I think also your levels feel good, is because as a VR movement it's very smooth.
Good level is smooth and the player can focus on the control of Astro.
Player can just forget about the technology and focus on the magic.
Yes, it's just fun.
There's a few moments that I think that are really cool in the game, especially when you get to lean a little bit. And I've seen so many people play when we did demos, when you have a little wall here in one of our city levels, and the player is supposed to lean a little bit to see what's behind the wall, to see the platform and move forward. And what you've done is that you put a couple of enemies behind the wall. So the little enemies come from behind the wall, you kill them, and so the first reaction you have is to go and check what was behind the wall, where they came from.
You try to make it obvious that, yeah, you can smash into this.
You're biting, you're satisfying. Yeah.
That kind of interaction, I think, really takes you as the human player right into that kind of game.
Yeah.
So you don't forget, I'm here too.
Yeah.
I have to make the motivation. What player can see from here? And what do you want to do from here?
And I feel like I'm being cool and it's like that. When the magician behind the scene is doing the work and you just enjoy it. The emotions are just like flowing in a way that is like, what I'm seeing right now, what I'm feeling, you're in a zone of happiness, you know? It's the beauty of good game design, level design, so.
Thank you.
For the players.